1940, if you were a hep cat, you wore a zoot suit with its replete and ripe stripe and draped shape. Yes, sir, the zoot suit was all root, and it was created by one of these three men. Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Harold Fox.
Number two.
My name is Harold Fox.
Number three.
And my name is Harold Fox. Oh, late.
Only one of these people is the real Harold Fox, and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. Now, let's meet our panel. Co-star of Murder, She Wrote, Ron Masak. Co-star of the new movie of the week, Final Verdict, Dana Hill. Soap opera star of All My Children, Walt, Willie. And from a current affair columnist, Cindy Adams. Here's the host of To Tell the Truth, Alex Trebek.
Thank you, Burton. You are bad. All right. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning and welcome to our show and welcome, panelists. Let's get to the first story represented by these three challengers, all three of whom claim to be Harold Fox. I, Harold Fox, created the Zoot Suit. If you look up the definition of a Zoot Suit in Webster's Dictionary, you'll read that I coined the name. It's a flashy suit with a thigh-length jacket, wide padded shoulders, and peg-top trousers tapering to narrow cuffs. It was the fashion rage in America during World War II, particularly popular in the big cities and among the big band musicians. Duke Ellington, Louis Armstrong, and Nat King Cole were all customers of mine. The long watch chain, which completed the Zoot Suit ensemble, was inspired by the pull chain on the old-fashioned toilet. The suit was immortalized in song by the Andrews Sisters, and years later by a hit musical. It did cause some problems, though. In Los Angeles, it was banned when bloodshed erupted between Navy sailors and Chicano Zoot Suiters. Its popularity faded, but its memory lives on, and it's signed Harold Fox. We'll find out more about this Zoot Suiter after this message.
Watch Prime Games and be eligible to win these great prizes. Hatteras Hammock's unique single-seater hanging porch or garden swing. Hand-woven cotton rope promises durability in many relaxing hours from Hatteras Hammocks. Dr. Scholl's Stimu-Roll, Callus Care, and Comfort Rest. The perfect kit for pampering your feet from Dr. Scholl. And Soft Heat Electric Heater. The safe, efficient, comfortable way to warm any room in your home. Soft Heat, the original hot water-filled heater from Intertherm.
Now, for your home and shop, one amazing blade that cuts through practically anything. This is new Multi-Disc. It's safe, it won't break or shatter. It's amazingly flexible. It will never bind or kick back your work. Multi-Disc cuts through this rock-hard ash baseball bat. It cuts through copper and iron pipes. Plastic pipes are cut off clean. There's no melting. Multi-Disc is diamond and carbide throughout. It's one of the best grinding wheels on the market. It shapes tile, grinds away paint, rust, and debris in seconds. Call toll-free or send for Multi-Disc now and start saving hundreds of dollars on single-purpose blades and wheels. Best of all, Multi-Disc will work on any rotary tool in your home or shop. Put it on your household drill and it cuts like magic. Multi-Disc cuts like a blade and grinds like a wheel. And you can use it on any rotary tool you own. Multi-Disc sands for mica while it cuts so there's no chipped edges. Call or send now. Cut perfect angles and grind curves in ceramic tile. Cuts picture frame perfect moldings and trim. Hobbyists love it for detailing plastics, metal, and wood. Now, in this limited time offer, you get two Multi-Discs, a universal arbor to assure they'll fit all your rotary tools, and our unconditional money-back guarantee, all for only $12.98. Order now.
Obviously, we're dealing with a very colorful story panel. These three gentlemen claim to be Harold Fox, the man who invented the Zoot Suit. Cindy, you start us off.
Number one, sir, what did you charge for your first Rudely Toot Zoot?
I don't remember what I charged, but I didn't get paid.
So it doesn't matter.
Number two, how did you originally get the name for the Zoot?
Well, we were looking for something to end all things, my brother and I, and Z's at the end of the alphabet. And for musicians, they were crazy about it when I showed them some of my drawings.
Number three, were you considered a sex object for having been so avant-garde and so way out?
Well, yes. I've been married four times, so I guess I'm kind of a sex object in a way.
Well, at least four women considered him to be a sex object.
You got custody of your wardrobe.
Yeah, Walt?
Number two, what makes a pair of pants peg-topped? I don't know what that means.
Well, they come up high, and then there's about a four-inch lap over. And then they come down to a point, which is the narrow part at the bottom, which you're supposed to almost take the hide off when you pull them on.
Great, I can use all my hide, though. Number three, what was the width of these lapels? They're so wide. What was the width in inches?
Well, the idea was everything would be extreme. So everything was wider, longer.
So it was up to the individual customer.
Extremes were paying off in those days. Dana?
Number one, it says there was a musical about it. Who starred in that musical and who directed it?
Honey, that was on the West Coast, and at the time I was on the East Coast, and I didn't come out here.
Okay, and number two, what the bloodshed between the Navy sailors and the Chicano Zoot Suiters, what caused that?
Well, I always figured it was a matter of costumes.
Okay.
Ronnie, your outfit today is certainly different from that of a Zoot Suit.
Well, I wore this in honor of having Dennis Weaver on the show yesterday. This is my McCloud Zoot Suit.
I see. Okay.
I made that up. Number three, you listed, I don't ever remember seeing Louis Armstrong in a Zoot Suit, but there's another very famous band leader who was famous for wearing a white Zoot Suit. Do you know who that would be, number three?
Yes, that was Cab Calloway.
The show Zoot Suit number two starred a very famous actor. As a matter of fact, he was nominated for an Academy Award. Do you know who that would be, sir?
I should, but I'm getting old and I can't think of it at the moment.
I know how you feel. I'm getting old and I can't remember the question.
All right. All three gentlemen certainly looked the part. Time's up for you, panel. It's time for you to vote for the man you think is the real Harold Fox. Is it number one? Is it number two? Or is it number three, the creator of the Zoot Suit? Our team of challengers will receive $500 for each incorrect vote, with a minimum guarantee of $1,000. And if our panel is fooled completely, as they were twice yesterday, the team will receive $3,000. I hate to keep rubbing it in.
He just doesn't let it go, does he?
No, I don't. Cindy, who did you vote for?
Well, there is no doubt in my mind because I never make a mistake. And it happens to be number two. I just want you all to know, I happen to know for an absolute fact, it is undoubtedly number two.
All right, Walt?
I don't have near that confidence, but I bought the answer about the peg-top pants, so I'm going to go with number two as well.
Interesting. Dana?
I don't know. Anybody who's been married four times and has a great mustache like that looks like he invented the Zoot Suit to me. I say number three.
Wait a minute. Married four times, a mustache, and inventing the Zoot Suit, they go together?
I don't know. They just, in my mind, go together.
Well, they could.
Yes. Ron?
Well, they all have the answers. I mean, number two knew about the peg leg pants, and number three knew about Cap Calloway. But I like number one's answer about the fact that he didn't get paid for the first one. And he also was right about Zoot Suit being an East... He was in the East Coast, and Zoot Suit was a West Coast, a play that starred Edward James Olmos. So I voted for number one.
Well, the votes are in. Let's recap. We're not going to be stumped today because each of our challengers has received a vote. Number one got one vote. Number two has picked up two, and number three got a vote also. Let's find out who our real cool cat is on our program today. Will the real Harold Fox please stand up? Number three. Harold, are all three of you wearing your clothes today?
Yes, all three.
You kept a lot of the stuff. Have you kept any of the original designs?
Yes, it's in the museum. Ford Museum. And that's why I didn't get the Zoot Suit to wear. They wouldn't release it. However, I needed something conservative, so I made this one.
You made this up especially for our program. Well, thank you for that.
Once in a while, you have to be conservative, right?
You bet. Let's find out about our imposters. Number one, you got a vote. Tell me about yourself.
My name is Tony Dyer, and I'm a carnival pitchman and concessionaire.
Good for you. Number two.
My name is Oliver Aubrey, and I'm a semi-retired preacher and businessman.
Well, there were three incorrect votes at $500 apiece, and that means the team will receive $1,500, and you are all terrific Zoot Suiters. Thank you for being with us on To Tell the Truth. In a moment, we'll come back with a woman whose husband cheated on her.
All across America, women create curls that hold with a very special shampoo, Wash and Curl. Its special curl strengtheners really work. Wash and Curl, the curling shampoo.
The smart way to lose weight, control your appetite, and get the calcium your bones need. Only Permathin does it. Appetite control plus calcium in one little caplet.
Brittle nails that break and won't grow? Get Nutri-Nail. Short, brittle nails grow in just 5 to 7 days. Nutri-Nail. Short, brittle nails grow. Guaranteed.
Bring home a holiday treat for the whole family. Matilda on Home Video. From the author of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, a delightful fairy tale of a girl with the power to make dreams come true. Starring Danny DeVito and Mara Wilson in a movie full of mischief and magic. Matilda from Columbia TriStar Home Video. Own it now at a great low price.
Hi, Bob Vila here to show you a unique new Craftsman tool no home should be without. Craftsman Handy Cut Utility Cutters. The one tool you can count on for all kinds of tough cutting jobs. Craftsman Handy Cut does the job of utility knives, carpet knives, shears, shop cutters, and more. Look how tough it is to make a good cut through this damaged garden hose with a utility knife. Craftsman Handy Cut gets it done in one clean cut. It's a terrific small branch and shrub pruner. Shears or shop cutters can't trim vinyl flooring as easily as the Craftsman Handy Cut. Use the Craftsman Handy Cut to cut nearly any common household material, including rope, plastic, leather, vinyl, and rubber. Call now, and you can order your Craftsman Handy Cut for only $19.99. And remember, when you buy from Sears, your satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back.
To order your Craftsman Handy Cut, get your Sears card or other credit card ready and call 1-800-247-7474. That's 1-800-247-7474. Call right now.
We're back, and it's time to meet our next team of challengers.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Peggy Vaughan.
Number two.
My name is Peggy Vaughan.
Number three.
My name is Peggy Vaughan.
Panel, I have a feeling this story is going to get you going, really. It's up to you to find the real Peggy Vaughan. Here's her story. I, Peggy Vaughan, am a psychological consultant. 17 years ago, my husband confessed he had been to bed with 15 different women. At the time, it was very painful, but I could find no easy way out. I stayed in the marriage because we had been together for so many years, and I believed he still loved me. I loved him. For years, I suspected he was having affairs, but I waited. I never confronted him. When he finally volunteered the truth, he and I were ready to start a new beginning. Our marriage became solid and monogamous again. I also helped start a national support group for survivors of affairs. The truth is that just because you love and marry someone doesn't make you immune to sexual or romantic feelings towards another person. Married people are expected to deny those feelings. And if they don't, the answer all too often is divorce. Breaking up a marriage is not the only answer. In my book, The Monogamy Myth, I help you prevent an affair, survive an affair, and most importantly, save your sanity. And it's signed Peggy Vaughan. Start the questioning off with you, please.
Number one, how many years had you been married when this happened?
Six.
You were married six, and it was 17 years ago. And number two, you are still together with the same man?
Yes.
How do you know he's not having an affair now?
Because we've communicated and worked things out.
Number three, obviously there's a joke there, but it's a little silly. Going to bed with 15 different women, that was at separate times, wasn't it?
I sincerely hope so.
You're terrible.
You shocked Dana on that one, Ron.
Well, I was trying to
course, my question I got right off the bat. Number one, did you have any affairs of your own?
No.
When you knew your husband was fooling around, you didn't. And number two, what are the signs?
There was some distancing that I just sensed, and that was the first indication.
And number three, it says you're a psychological consultant. What exactly is that? Are you a psychologist? Do you have training? What does that mean?
The consultant part comes from working in businesses, corporations on male-female issues.
Okay, and...
Walt, over to you.
Number two, why did you not confront your husband if you had these feelings, these suspicions that he was having an affair?
Because at that time, being young, and I was in denial. I was not mature enough then.
Number three, how many chances should somebody get?
It's not something that's easy to answer. It's really up to the individual person, and it's more like what's the chances for later than how many times it happened maybe before.
Number one, we always hear about men committing adultery. This is a tough question. Do more men or women commit adultery?
Men.
Cindy?
And number three, if he had 15 different affairs, he's got to wind up in a bottle on the shelf in Harvard. What's so great about him?
Well, from my perspective, what was great was that I'd known him all my life. We were childhood sweethearts, and we'd been married 18 years at the time I found out for sure. And he was already, to me, you know, the man I loved and wanted.
Number two, what I meant was, what was so great about him physically that 15 different ladies would want him?
He was a very charismatic character, and not that he was so physically attractive, but he had a lot of panache.
Spell charismatic S-E-X, I guess, Cindy, huh?
Believe me.
All right, your time is up. Time now to vote for the woman you think is the real Peggy Vaughan, the victim of a philandering husband. Is it number one, number two, or number three? Ron, we'll start with you.
Well, they all had wonderful answers, Alex. Number one said she'd only been married 6 years, and that was 17 years ago. And number three said she'd been married 18 years when it happened and had known him all those years, and that would make 35 years of marriage. And you got to love someone, I guess, that long to stay with it. And she had nice, soft-spoken answers.
All righty.
Number three.
Dana?
I like that, actually, but the reason I didn't think it was number three is because she said 18 years and then 17 years, that means 35 years. She doesn't look 55, which is about what I figured she'd have to be, so I didn't think so. I think it's number one. I don't know why. Thank God I've never been through this, so I just think it's number one.
You're very young, Dana. We hope that you'll never have to go through.
Exactly.
Walt?
I like the answer that number three gave about how many chances should somebody get, because I think that should be allowed up to the couple. It made a lot of sense to me.
All right, Cindy?
Number three, I couldn't understand what her answer, what she found attractive about her. Number two, I believed her answer, but I never got to number one, and I figured she's got to be the one just because I never got to her. Number one.
That's as good a rationale.
What do you want?
All right, number one, you got two votes. Number two received no votes. And number three, you got two votes as well. Let's find out who really knows how to handle her affairs. Will the real Peggy Vaughan please stand up? Number three. Peggy, we'll get back to you in just a moment. Number one, you convinced two of members of our panel. Who are you?
My name's Judy Orbus, and I'm a secretary with the Coca-Cola Company.
Are you married or single?
I'm married.
All right. Number two?
My name is Sheila Belkin, and I'm a portrait painter.
Portrait painter. How nice. Well, there were two incorrect votes at $500 a vote, and that means the team will receive $1,000. Since we've been talking about him, ladies and gentlemen, we might as well meet him now. Peggy Vaughan's once philandering husband, a man who obviously got his cake and ate it, too. Let's welcome James Vaughan. James, it's very good of you to appear on television with us because, as you know, you're in a very difficult spot. When you went into the marriage, I'm sure it was not your plan to cheat on Peggy. How did it come about? What happened?
Well, you're right. I never had any idea that I would end up having affairs. I didn't know anyone who had had an affair. No one in my family, to my knowledge, had ever had one. It was 11 years into our marriage when I began to travel a lot and began to see other men having affairs for the first time. And I was shocked at first, but after observing them for a while, I got to thinking, hey, maybe I could do this too. And I actually asked, you know, how can you do that and not break up your marriage?
James, if you had one word of advice to give to all the men who are watching today to help them avoid some of the problems you encountered, what would that advice be?
Think about it in advance, because nobody is immune. We all think we are until we find ourselves in a situation.
Okay, thank you very much, Peggy. Thank you also, both of you, for being with us on To Tell the Truth. We'll be back to play one-on-one with someone from the studio audience right after this.
Remember when a candy bar used to cost a dime? Nowadays, it seems like you have to use a credit card to pay for just about everything. Unfortunately, credit cards are getting more and more homeowners in trouble. But the Money Store can help you consolidate all of your high-rate credit cards and other loans into one low monthly payment. All it takes is just one phone call, and you could be on your way to saving hundreds each month. You can't buy a candy bar for a dime anymore, but you can call the Money Store toll-free at 1-800-LOAN-YES.
Does your back ache even when you sit? Wait. Introducing the Contour Seat Cushion turns any chair into the best seat in the house. Our exclusive two-layer design provides superior comfort and support. Soft white foam fingers adjust to your shape, while the firm blue layer gives comforting support. The extra tall back cushion fits your natural curves, from your lower back all the way up to your shoulder blades. The unique wedge boosts your posture and repositions your body to help reduce strain on your lower back. Plus, our special tailbone cutout helps relieve pressure around the base of your spine, reducing stiffness and fatigue. What a relief! It's the most complete seating system ever, all for only $19.95. Order now and we'll include this washable cover and $8 value free. So you can use the cushions together or alone. You get the back cushion, the seat wedge, and the cover. Order now.
Call 1-800-346-8900 now to order and receive your washable cover free. That's 1-800-346-8900. Order now.
Now, five times a week, check local listings for station and time.
January is a month to watch. Game Show Network is hot, hot, hot. January is a month to watch. Game Show Network is hot, hot, hot. Mmm, whoa. January is a month to watch. Game Show Network.
Time now to play one-on-one with someone from our studio audience. Burton obviously is trying to bring back the Zoot Suit. He looks very good in his. Are you going to keep that one?
Oh, boy, wouldn't that be nice?
Yes, it would.
Yes.
Who do you have to work with us today?
Well, Alex, today we have a junior high school science teacher from La Palma, California. I'd like you to meet Bill Poloni.
Hiya, Bill.
Hello. How are you?
I know why Burton picked you, because the two of you are color-coordinated. All right, Bill, here's your chance to play one-on-one and win $500. First, I want you to meet a gentleman who has two stories to tell. Let's welcome Ken Butler. Bill, Ken's going to tell us two stories, only one of which is the truth. If you can spot the true story, you'll earn $500. Ken, what's your first story?
I can make music on almost anything. I can even play a hockey stick.
Well, I'm a hockey player, and the only time I've made music with my hockey stick is when I got hit over the head with one. May or may not be the truth, Bill. Let's take a listen to his second story.
I own the house that was featured in the hit movie Home Alone.
All righty. Panel, you each get to ask one question to help Bill and our audience earn the $500. Cindy, we're going to begin with you. Is he a hockey stick musician?
No. But, sir, what is the range of notes that you can get off a hockey stick?
Well, the hockey stick has strings, and it only has two strings, so the range is, I don't know. But it's whatever, it's...
Limited.
Limited range.
Limited is a good word. Walt?
Is there a certain song that you play on all these varieties of things?
Not really, no.
Dana?
What other sports items can you make music with?
Just about any sports item.
Ron.
Is it electric or acoustic?
Well, they're amplified with small microphones.
Bill, you've heard Ken's first story. Now to story number two, that he is the owner of the house used in the film Home Alone. Cindy.
How much money did you earn for renting it?
I'd rather not say, but it was a lot of money, and I was very happy to do it.
Walt?
What town was this house in?
Evanston, Illinois.
Dana.
How long were they there filming?
2 months.
Where did you stay while they were filming?
They put us up in a hotel. We stayed there some of the time.
All right, thank you, Ken. Bill, you've heard the cross-examination from our panel. Does Ken play a hockey stick, or does he own the house used in the film Home Alone?
Well, the man looks like he owns a house to me.
Does? Well, let's find out. Ken, what is your true story?
To tell the truth, I play a hockey stick.
Even though you're wearing the right color today, Bill, you weren't right, and we have to be content with giving you a nice gift backstage. Thank you for playing one-on-one. And to Ken Butler, who will be back with a demonstration in a little while, $1,000 for stumping Bill in the audience. We'll break now. We'll come back after this.
24 hours a day, 365 days a year, your baby is stuck in a stuffy diaper. Unfortunately, other diapers aren't designed to breathe, not even cloth-like ones. Here's the first diaper that is. New Breathable Pampers Premium. Made with airflow material along the sides, Breathable Pampers Premium is designed to let air flow in without letting wetness leak out. It helps keep your baby's skin dry and healthy, which is truly a breath of fresh air. Pediatricians know air helps keep skin healthy, so Pampers created the first breathable diaper. Make them happy. Keep them dry. New Breathable Pampers Premium.
If you've ever struggled with a handheld trimmer, you'll love this revolutionary new kind of trimmer on wheels. Just look how easy it rolls on those two big wheels and glides in any direction on this front-mounted mobile. It's perfect for trimming around rocks, along fences, buildings, sidewalks, and in all those hard-to-reach corners. The new DR is also a mower. It cuts tall grass, waist-high weeds, even wet grass and rough areas with never-before ease. There's no steel blade to bend or dull. You'll just love what the DR Trimmer Mower can do for you and your property.
Call toll-free 1-800-915-2020 for your big free package all about the revolutionary DR Trimmer on Wheels plus special savings now in effect. That's 1-800-915-2020 for free DR details.
At Game Show Network, there's always something fun happening on Club AM.
Monday on Club AM, we've got something you've all been waiting for.
Yep, and that can only mean one thing.
Our bonus round flashback of the year countdown concludes.
Do you think we'll have a big drum roll when we have the number one bonus round?
I'm not sure, but if we can't have a drum roll, I can bring a cinnamon roll.
Well, that won't make as much noise as a drum roll.
Only if you smack your lips while you eat it.
True.
Don't miss the next Club AM, 9 a.m. Eastern, 6 a.m. Pacific.
We're back, and Ken has brought along a sampling of his smaller instruments. He has a much larger collection, and they will be on display at the Metropolitan Museum in just a couple of months. Now, you've heard musicians refer to their instruments as their axe, and you've seen in many movies as either a violin or a machine gun in something like this. No, we have a real axe, a musical axe. If you're wondering what to do with your old tennis racket, you might consider this. If you're considering making a percussion instrument, how about this one? And we even have a broom. But we talked about the hockey stick and the fact that Ken can play the hockey stick. Everybody's dying to hear this.
Okay,
go for it.
There's a little swizzle string, a stick drink mixer on there, but I'll show you
how it works. Of course, all instruments have them.
You have to wear a pair of jeans to fit it in your pocket properly. Here we go. A little funky bass. Here we go.
Funky, funky.
Speaking for To Tell the Truth, the Mark Goodson Television Group.